Hello students, welcome to the video lecture series of artificial intelligence. Today we are going to learn one more heuristic search method, that is problem reduction. I am your instructor Bhumin Mandalia for this video lecture series of artificial intelligence. Today's outline, that means the topics we are going to cover up, that first is Andor graph, second is AO star algorithm, and last is its example. So these three contents we are going to cover up in today's session. Now let us start with the Andor graph, that is our first topic. Andor graph is used for representing the solution of problems that can be solved by decomposing them into a set of smaller subproblems. So using Andor graph, we are going to divide our problem into a set of subproblems. So this decomposition or reduction generates arcs that we call AND arcs, and one AND arc may point to any number of successor nodes. So in previous scenario, in best first search, we were using OR graph, and in OR graph, all the nodes are connected by the OR edge. So in ANDOR graph, the graph will have the nodes which will be connected by AND edge also and OR edge also. That means the nodes will be connected by both the edges, that means AND and OR both. Okay. So if nodes are connected by AND edge, that means both the nodes must be traversed perfectly. So this is the example of ANDOR graph, in which we are having one OR edge also and one AND edge also. So our goal is to acquire TV set. So if we want to acquire TV set, then the first goal is to steal the TV set. See, one thing, that is to steal the TV set. So in this case, we can say this is connected by OR edge, that means this is connected by OR edge, okay, and these two nodes are connected by AND edges. So the second alternative is earn some money and buy TV set, okay. So this is connected by AND, that means both these activities must be performed if you want to have a TV set, okay. So earn some money and buy TV set, and using OR edge we are having only one option, that is steal TV set. So see, sometimes if we consider heuristic function, that we may not have the ethical solution. For example, let's say if I want to have the TV set, then definitely stealing TV set is not the better option. Okay. So the better option is these two activities, that earn some money and then purchase the TV set. So this is one of the better options for having the TV set. So this is a formal example of AND OR graph. Okay, so this is the formal example of AND OR graph. So in AND OR graph, likewise, these the edges will be connected by OR also, and edges will be connected by AND also. Okay, so this is the example of formal example of AND OR graph. Now let us start with the, let's say one more example is there. See, let me say one array is there, for example, let's say 50, minus 9, 2, 10, minus 100, 0, let's say 5, 47, up to these, there is 100 elements array. That means in this array, we are having in total 100 elements. So let us say I want to find maximum number from this 100 element array. Okay, so I want to find maximum number from this 100 elements array. Now one, let's say assumption is there, for example, say in this array to find the maximum number, I don't have any program. That means I have to perform this task manually. I don't have any program. Okay. So can we say that this task must be performed manually? So if we want to perform this task manually, then these 100 elements array can be found with maximum number in somewhat different manner. So what we are going to do, that we are going to divide, listen everyone, what we are going to do, we are going to divide 100 elements array, we are going to divide 100 elements array in 10 elements chunks. So we will divide 100 elements array in 10 elements chunks. So see, listen everyone, all these chunks can be manipulated separately. For example, let's say 50 minus 9 2, this is one of the chunk of 10 elements, or we can say division of 10 elements. Okay, let's say after that 10 minus 100 0, this is also one of the element, or we can say 10 elements chunk. Okay, likewise, next is 5 47 and something, this is the third chunk, or we can say third division. So likewise, each and every chunk is having, each and every division is having 10 elements. So can we say that likewise we have total made 10 divisions for this one? Okay, so in total we have made total 10 divisions. So from this 10 division, let's say here 2 is minimum, 50 is maximum number here, 10 is maximum number here, 47 is maximum number. So likewise, total 10 maximum numbers I have found. Okay, so from these 10 maximum numbers, I am not having any program. So once I have found the maximum number, let's say 47. Okay, so from these 10 maximum numbers. Okay, so can we say that this 47 will be definitely maximum from 100 elements? So this 47 will be definitely maximum from 100 elements. Getting my point or not? So this 47 will be definitely maximum from 100 elements. So what I want to say to you people, that 47 is maximum from 100 elements. So can we say that after dividing this particular problem into sub problems, I have made this problem somewhat easier? Okay, so that is why we can say I have made the problem easier using decomposition. So these all, listen everyone, these all edges are connected by AND edges, because all of them must be solved. All of the edges must be solved, right? So all these edges are connected by AND. Then and only then we will be able to get the final maximum number, right? So this is the scenario of problem reduction. Problem reduction, that means once we decompose the problem, all the sub problems are connected by AND edge, and all those sub problems must be solved. Okay, so all sub problems must be solved. Okay, so this is the scenario of AND OR graph. Okay, now listen, next topic is the AND OR graph, that is AO star algorithm. So let us trace this algorithm. First of all, let me read the algorithm. Place the initial graph on open with a single node. For example, let's say we are having node A. So this node is termed as my open node, because which is one my only my one single node. So place the initial graph on open with single node. Next is traverse the graph following current path, accumulating nodes that have not been expanded. That means we are going to traverse the path with the nodes that are not been expanded. So let's say A is not expanded because it was open. So we will expand it by having some more nodes, let's say B, C, D. Next, select any of the node N and explore it. So any of the node can be selected and we are going to explore it. If it has no successor, then call it as a value of futility. See, futility is just like a threshold value. Listen everyone, futility is just like a threshold value. And using that threshold value, we will be able to terminate our search procedure. So if futility is not reached, then compute f dash of n for each successor. So this f dash of n is equals to my heuristic value, right? Now next is, if f dash n is equals to 0, then mark the node as solved. If f dash n is equals to 0, then mark that node is equals to solved. Solved, that means what? I have solved this problem, and f dash of n is equals to 0, that means heuristic value is 0. Heuristic value denotes what? The distance between my current state and goal state. So heuristic value is 0, that means there is no distance, and if there is no distance, then I have achieved my goal state, right? So this f dash of n is equals to 0, then mark the node as solved. Now change the value of f dash of n for newly created node to reflect its successor by back propagation. Okay. See, this step we are going to understand with example. So please be aware. Change the value of f dash for newly created node and reflect its successor by backpropagation. Next is, whenever possible, use the most promising node. See, in ANDOR graph, in AO star algorithm, every time we don't require the value, which is the node which is having the least heuristic value. Sometimes we may also have the ethical path, which is somewhat ethical, right? So if starting node is solved, then or value is greater than futility, then stop, otherwise repeat step number 2. So let's say if starting node, which is my, let's say A, is solved, or we can say value of heuristic value is greater than futility that we have assumed, then we have to stop, otherwise continue with step number 2. Okay, so let us have the example of this ANDOR graph. See, in this example, these all nodes are there. Let's say the nodes are A, B, and C, and D. See, this C and D are connected by AND edges. The heuristic values are these one, let's say 5, 3, and 4. Okay, so from this 5, 3, and 4, if we consider the heuristic value, so which is having the least heuristic value? So, for example, if we consider node A, so in node B we are having B, C, and D, okay, right? So node B, C, and D, here it is having the value 5, 3, and 4. These are connected by what? They are connected by AND edge, right? So 4 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1, so here it will be having the value 9, and here it was having only value 5. So can we say that this is connected by OR and this is connected by AND, right? So see, step number 5, listen everyone, which we had here, step number 5 means what? Change the value of f dash for newly created node to reflect its successor by backpropagation. So listen everyone, this 4 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1, that is 9 value, is reflected using backpropagation technique. So this successor's value are modified on this predecessor, that is value 9, using backpropagation. Now from this, let's say this is step number 1. Let's say step number 2. So from this value, from this tree, we are having B, C, and D in form of nodes. Okay, here we are having the value 3 and 4. Total heuristic value was 9 here because they are connected by AND. So let us explore this one because it was having least heuristic value. So from B, we are having two nodes, like let's say E and F. Okay, now E and F are having the value, let's say 8 and 2. Okay, so if they are connected by AND edge, then can we say that here it will be having 8 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1. So my final answer of heuristic will be 12 here, because both of them must be evolved. Now this 12 plus 1 will be what? 11. So here it will be having the value 11. So can we say that from 11 and 9 is lesser, so definitely we will be able to expand 9 here. So from C we are having two nodes, let's say G and H. Okay, let's say G and H are also connected by AND, and they are also having the value, heuristic value, let's say 1 and 2. So here it will be 1, 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So my final heuristic value will be what? 5. So that 5 plus 1 will be reflected here, so that will be 6. And 6 plus 4, that is 12. Sorry, 6 plus 4, that is 10. So plus 1 plus 1, so it will be 12 here. So likewise, from child node, my most parent node will be evaluated. Okay. So we can say from child node, my most parent node is changed value with backpropagation. Okay, so this value modification is called as backpropagation, right? So this is the example of AND OR graph, and this is the tracing of AO star algorithm. Okay, so this is the tracing of AO star algorithm. So this AO star algorithm tracing can be understood only and only using AO star algorithm, or we can say AND OR graph. So AND OR graph, AND OR, that means AO star. Okay, so this is the example of problem reduction, because after decomposing the problem into sub problems, as we had the example of maximum number, it will be very much easier to solve the problem perfectly. Okay, so this is the problem reduction approach. Thank you for paying your attention. Thank you, students.